Hi fam fam, welcome back to the Simplified series. Today I'm gonna talk to you about how to transition to floor sleeping. So if you haven't seen my videos yet on why we floor sleep and how we floor sleep, I really recommend you looking at the how video. I talk about how I put cushions around myself, and really that is like my number one tip when it comes to floor sleeping is ease yourself into it. Support your body in a way that makes it familiarized with the ground, similarly to how you were in your bed. If you go straight to like a flat, hard ground, it's gonna hurt. Your body has a lot of adjustments. You're putting it in a position that it's not used to being in, even though the changes are minor, for like 6 to 8 hours in an evening, if not more. So you have to understand that easing into it is what's gonna allow you to transition more successfully and comfortably. So I like cushioning myself, number two. I like propping myself. I like making sure that all the areas that might be kind of just a little more pressured or a little more uncomfortable are eased and it becomes habitual to be on the ground. Now, a lot of you guys might ask, well, if you're gonna use all these cushions, why floor sleep anyways? You still save money because mattresses and bed frames are expensive. You still save space because you can pick all of this up off the ground and have that space around. You still save not wasting and having to produce and make a lot of these chemicalized, overproduced beds and bed frames. Like, I can't tell you how many beds and mattresses get thrown away just in this neighborhood alone. It's crazy. And I just think, where is all this going? Somebody commented recently, like, where are these mattresses that are getting thrown away going? They go into our landfills, they pollute our environment. It's super, super wasteful. So I really love the floor sleeping. And if you can make it happen, it's a really good for your back. You can align your spine. And this is just a caveat. It's not made for all people. We all have different body shapes, styles, and sizes. So for some of you, you're gonna really want a cushion, but you can also not come down to a flat ground, but do like a tatami type Japanese setup or futon, something that folds up off the ground so that you can transition from your bed to the floor. Tip number three that I have for you is try as much as possible to get on your back. This might not be comfortable right off the bat, but staying on your back is what is gonna allow that spine to align. A lot of you that are having trouble floor sleeping, your side sleepers, your stomach sleepers, and you're just kinking yourself up in those positions and the floor is not supporting your spine in alignment. So getting on your back as much as possible and allowing spaces like the curves in your lower back or your shoulder blades to be cushioned or fulfilled by using a mattress topper or something to support it, propping yourself, cushioning yourself, is gonna allow you to transition to that a lot more comfortably and in alignment. Floor sleeping, you're not gonna get the comfort or the benefits if your spine is not aligned while you're doing it. Number four, keep in mind if you've been in bed for most of your life, your body has positioned or shaped itself to be comfortable in that sleeping position, and sleeping is almost half your life. So if you're transitioning to something where you're completely open, completely flat, and I will say I tried making myself sleep completely flat for like the whole month of last month, all of August, and it was so not comfortable. I was like sore in my shoulders. My traps were really sore because I was like really open and perfectly flat. And while it was good for my body, it was pulling my muscles in ways that it wasn't used to being in for like 8 hours a night that I was so super sore. So what I started doing was I would bring all my pillows back down and sleep on the side when I felt like it, but as much as possible, sleep on my back, sleep on my back, sleep on my back. Then I'd get sore and I'd sleep back on my side, cushioned with the pillows again. And it started easing me into being able to sleep flat on my back a lot more successfully. So you wanna exercise and restore these areas that you feel are in pain or it's uncomfortable. I really like working with a physical therapist or somebody that's gonna check my body out and make sure that I'm attending to the areas that need attending to. Our bodies are like a vehicle or like our car that we use to get to and from and to experience the world on a daily basis. There is no reason that we should not be looking into it, getting checked out, and making sure things are working in line and smoothly so that we can continue to live life as proficiently as possible. So if you're doing something like transitioning to floor, make sure that you get checked by your PT or your chiropractor. to make sure that everything is in line. When you do have sorenesses or things that are going on, have them check it, verbalize it, ask them what type of exercises you can do to regain the balance that your body needs to be comfortable and support itself in alignment. And number two, the type of exercises, myofascial release, restoration, yoga, whatever, to loosen up those areas and joints so everything can come back together. Just because it's uncomfortable doesn't mean it's bad for you, but your body's saying, hey, something's off. Something doesn't feel right, so make sure that you get it checked out. Lastly, adjust as you need. As I said, I was trying to sleep on my back nice and flat. It really helped improve my posture, but I was so sore. So I adjusted by bringing the pillows back down. You guys know that a while ago, we used to sleep just straight flat on the floor. It could be tile or carpet underneath, and we would just lay a blanket down and sleep on the floor, and that was really great and minimal. But after a while, I really wanted some support in the curvatures of my spine, like in the back of my neck, my lower back and hips. And so we now sleep on a 3-inch memory foam mattress topper, still on the floor, still with the same benefits, but much, much more comfortable. So there's no wrong way to floor sleep. You don't even have to floor sleep. You can sleep on a bed if you like, and if that's what's comfortable for you, hey, that's okay. But if you find value and benefit in floor sleeping, I hope that these ways of transitioning to the floor help you out. Let me know that you like this video by hitting the thumbs up. Thank you guys so much for all your comments, conversations, and contributions within the community. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe and hit the bell notification too so you get notified when these episodes come out. I'll be seeing you guys in the next video. Remember to go out there, be good, be great. Most of all, be grateful, conquer your reality, be the best you that you can be, and I'll see you next time. Ciao.